Today I am going to discuss about Global Depository Receipt, GDR, because some of my students asked me to explain GDR. So we must know what is GDR. So GDR is an acknowledgement, or it is a financial instrument to raise foreign capital. So it is used to raise foreign capital. Say, as for example, an Indian company want to foreign capital, and on the other hand, there are some foreign investors who want to invest capital in Indian company, but they cannot contact with each other directly. For that, they need some intermediaries or middlemen, and that intermediaries are the overseas bank who has contact with both the Indian company and the foreign investors. So next, we have to know the mechanisms or steps how the GDR is issued. So at first, the Indian company will have contact with a domestic custodian bank and deposit their shares to this domestic custodian bank, and the domestic custodian bank will take care of the, then they will be the shares will be in the custody of the domestic custodian bank. And this domestic custodian bank will inform the overseas bank which is situated in a foreign country that they can sell the shares of this company. Then the overseas bank will contact the foreign investors that they can purchase shares of these Indian companies. The foreign investors will deposit their money to the overseas bank. Then the overseas bank will issue the GDR on behalf of the Indian company. So it's a certificate against the shares sold by the overseas bank. So we can say it is a certificate, or it is an acknowledgement of the shares that is sold by the overseas bank on behalf of the Indian company. So once it is issued as a GDR, it becomes a marketable instrument which can be marketed in a foreign market. It means it can be sold or purchased in the foreign market. So now you have to know that how the money is remitted. The first, the money, that is the investors who purchase the GDR, will deposit the money to the overseas bank. Now the overseas bank will deduct some of their expenditures or some charges, and the remaining amount will be sent to the Indian custodian bank, depository bank. And from this depository bank, the company can collect their foreign money. So it's a very easy thing. That is, only two agency plays a very important role in this transaction. First one is, it is the domestic